Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and we are about to work together for 1 hour. We're going to get so much done. We're going to feel great at the end of it. We're going to look at ourselves in the mirror and go, wow, you really did it. You did an hour of work. I'm so proud. You didn't have to. You could have put it off, but you did it. You sat down with Ashley, and you did it. We're going to use the Pomodoro technique, which means we'll do 2 25-minute work sections where I blast white noise. We'll have a 5-minute break in the middle. Don't worry. There is a break. Get up, do whatever you want. Do a funny little dance, get some more beverages, stretch. Or if you want some human interaction, you can stay with me. I love to chat. I will be chatting during the break. After the hour, we can call our mom. We can call out sick from work. We can clean our house. We can do whatever we want. Why? Because we already showed up. We already sat down. We already took care of business. How's that sound? Great. So for the first 25 minutes, I'm drinking a blackberry bubbly, and I will be working. I'm making an Eventbrite. That's what I will be working on for the first 25 minutes. I would love to know what you will be working on and what beverages you have. Wonderful. Well, without further delay, let's get comfortable. Ooh, make sure you're sitting in that seat just right. Remember, you're just going to work on something for 25 minutes. It's easy. It's peasy. The time flies. And yet, you will also be shocked at how much you get done. I can promise you that. Okay? Stick with the program. It never leads us astray. You're feeling good. I'm feeling good. Let's do this. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Wow. The timer shocks me always. I'm putting 5 minutes on the clock. Let's do a stretch. Let's do one where we put like our hands on the side of your table or just like spread out further than your shoulders and then just dip your shoulders a little bit. Ooh, I got my booster shot this morning and I can feel it in this shoulder dip. Wow. Okay, and then let's just do like a little pump. Mm-hmm. Oh, hello, sun. Love that. Gosh, what was I going to talk to you about? I had like so many things I wanted to discuss. And now I'm completely drawing a blank, as per usual, when I come out of my intense work brain. Okay, let me think. Things to discuss. My cat snoring. Can you hear her? I got her this, okay. So we got an accent chair. We have our couch. Thank God we got our couch. And then we were like, we need another seat in case, I don't know, someone ever comes over. So we got this accent chair that I love. Oh, I love it so much. It is, of course, from the Drew Barrymore Home Collection. I'm sure I've discussed it on the channel. I lose track of what I discuss, but it's almost impossible for me to talk about decorating and our LA apartment without mentioning the Drew Barrymore Home Collection. Everything she did was so good. It appears to be over though. Like no new products are coming out. When I first saw it in like 2019, there's like 500 products. Now there's like 50. And now even in the past week, like a bunch of things have disappeared. That's okay though, because I've got everything that I love. And so I got this chair and it's expensive. It's the most expensive thing. It's the most expensive chair I've ever bought. That's for sure. But it's so comfy and it's like, it's everything you want it to be. Mid-century, velvet, squishy. And we immediately, upon getting it in the apartment and setting it up, we found ourselves in a battle with our cat who just wants to sit on it. That's all she wants is to sit on this dark blue, like the ocean at night, velvet couch with this like rich walnut type wood. It's beautiful. Is it walnut? Probably not. It probably would not have been the price that it was. I am in my mind, walnut's like $800. And this chair, I think, was $200, which seems insane. But still, I just was like, new life, new us. We got this chair. And so I know from having cats and pets that if they do something you don't want them to do, you just have to commit to continuously correcting the behavior. So like every time I saw her on the couch, I would be like, no, and I would get her off. And then I know that it's going to be a struggle and we have to just like work on it. But if I hold to it, if I keep up the correction, and I always do it, every time I see her on the couch, I get her off. I mean, not the couch, the chair. The reason why I wanted to get her off, by the way, is because she, like the first night, she laid on it. She slept on it. We woke up in the morning. There was cat hair and even worse, a little drool on the seat. There was a little drool spot that we had to clean out. And I was like, I can't buy my cat a $200 cat bed. I just can't. It's our chair. It can't be a cat bed. So we both really committed to getting her off the chair every time we saw her. And then she was just like more vigilant about it than normal. Like she also has been really into trying to get on the kitchen counter and like walk across the stove because she can jump up onto the top of the fridge from there. And we have been adamant about her not going up on the kitchen counter because I don't want my cat walking on a gas stove. Have I already talked about this on here? I feel like I'm losing it. But anyway, I gave up. I gave up the battle. I gave up the battle on the chair. I bought her this little cushy thing from Target. She loves. It's like a little cocoon that she can sit in, but I can't stop her from going on the chair all the time. I don't know what happened. Something inside me broke. And I was like, all this animal wants is to be comfortable. And like, so what if she just ruins this chair? So what? What do you think? Have I made a horrible mistake? I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to spray her with water. That's like a thing people do with cats. I don't ever want her to be uncomfortable. The way I look at it is like, it's got to be kind of hard being a cat. A cat by herself in this apartment, you know, she can't talk to us. I mean, she communicates to us in her way, but like, we're just walking around here having conversations all the time and she doesn't get to be a part of that. So I'll just let her sit on the chair. Okay, I'm putting 25 minutes on the clock. I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. What are you going to do? Great, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Wow, that actually shocked me. Woo! Okay, that was an hour. We did it. I'll see you here on Wednesday at 10 a.m. Thank you so much for working with me. Okay, have a great day. I'll see you on Wednesday. Bye.